This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV 24/7.
Well, the military is occupying it. But at least for now, there's no such fear here in India. Millions of tourists from across the world come here to take in the sights. Not just that, 300 million Indians pack their bags domestically and travel within the country. So in such a booming scenario, travel and tourism management is an upcoming field. Let's take a closer look. It's 45 degrees in the shade and you're just itching to get away from the heat and dust of the city. Packing your bags and heading to Kasauli or Kuala Lumpur is now not a big deal. Shrinking global boundaries and India's growing purchasing power, the travel and tourism industry is witnessing a huge boom. More than 300 million domestic trips within India alone are made each year, and that number has slowly translated into a desire for international holidays. The Travel Agents Association of India estimates that the number of Indians making foreign journeys is expected to jump to more than 15% each year.
Because the summers have come early, the bookings have already started rolling in, and there are more disposable incomes and there are more destinations, and we hope to do rolling business this year much more than compared to last year.
Travel agencies, both big and small, are your best bet to negotiate the best price for your air ticket. And with a little bit of luck, the friendly travel agent could also pack in your vacation package with much more than what you bargained for. Navigating the huge maze of airlines, air tickets, and managing the flow of tourist traffic is a specialized study that you can get a grip on with travel and tourism management. Travel and tourism management entails three areas of specialization, as hospitality, travel and tourism, and sites and events. The business aspect is added to all of these by equipping students with management skills that include consumer research, marketing, event management, planning and development of tourism projects. So here's where you can study travel and tourism management. The Indian Institute of Travel and Tourism Management in Gwalior is an autonomous organization under the Ministry of Tourism and Culture. It's a premier institute in the country, offering training, education and research in the sustainable management of tourism and travel. Its focus is on meeting the changing needs of the tourism industry. It offers both graduate and postgraduate courses and also has a branch in Delhi. More details on the admission process online at iittm.org. Most established universities around the country also offer graduate and postgraduate diplomas in tourism and travel management. In Mumbai, Sophia Polytechnic offers a year-long PG diploma in travel and tourism management with a compulsory 3-month internship program. You can go there after pursuing a bachelor's degree in any discipline from a recognized university. Complete application details are available on their website at sophiacampus.com. Another institute is the Bhavari Institute that offers both undergraduate and postgraduate diplomas in this field. If Mumbai doesn't lure you, then head to Christ College in Bangalore. It offers both bachelor's and PG degrees in travel and tourism management. Located in the heart of the city, Christ College has integrated travel and tourism studies with its commerce program and emphasizes on communication and customer relations. Training programs are compulsory in the second year. But if you want to get away from the city, what better place to head to than Puducherry? The Puducherry University offers both MBA and PhD programs in tourism studies. More details online at pandivini.edu.in. Most institutes run placement programs where graduates get placed not just in premier travel agencies across the world like Thomas Cook, Cox and Kings and CETA, but also with airlines to help out with ticketing. But if you don't want a 9-to-5 job and want to get your feet wet in a whole new industry, paddle your way into adventure tourism. Rishikesh has immersed a grand deal for the country's adventure industry. The 45-kilometer stretch from Biasi to Rishikesh draws in lakhs of adventure seekers each year to indulge in the finest water sports the country has to offer. It's an adrenaline-filled 5 months when it's feeding service season. The lure of the Ganga and the chance to meet similar-minded thrill seekers prompted 24-year-old Nikesh Joshi to give up a lucrative career in hotel management and head to the river to set up his own business.
He was going inside the pool. Okay, because this is a pool, you can't compare with some other management studies or something like that. Okay? Because in this pool, you need to be very practical. Okay? Because you need to know that how a raft goes, okay? What are the rapids, what are the risk elements in that, because this is a part of adventure. Okay? Because if you think that you will just do it from the book, you can't get it.
The 45 to 50 rafting camps provide employment to the locals and are fueled by young entrepreneurs like Nikesh wanting to make the best of the river.
Everyone I say that we got the richest customer in our country. Okay? But here in this field, you know, it's every day we are running in the same river. Okay? And if you do any work, you get really good from that, okay? Because if you are sitting in front of a company, like, but why it's interesting, you know? Because every day we get some different kind of stuff.
As more and more people sign up for unusual holidays, looking to pepper their vacations with activities, adventure tourism is on the go in India. And with an entire generation looking beyond traditional job profiles, it's finding more takers. So if you're physically fit and specialize in any sport or activity like rafting, trekking or mountaineering, or are just a person who sees sites that are off the beaten track, then this vacation is for you. From mild to wild, for sure there's an adventure out there for you. It's just up to you to make it your job to find it.
This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV 24/7.